beloved brothers and sisters in Christ. Because Matthew, our brother, who is your relative, your friend, your confidant, is now to be ordained to the order of priests, let us consider what's about to happen in the light of the Word of God that he chose for this salvation. Now, because I'm relatively inexperienced in this business, I'm going to rely on the Word of God, but also on Pope Benedict XVI and Pope Francis to help us understand Matthew's vocation as a Franciscan priest. In the first reading from Isaiah, the prophet proclaims that he has been anointed by the Lord to bring the good news to the afflicted, to comfort Zion with the announcement of a year of favor. Now, what does this mean, a year of favor? The background in the prophet's mind was the Jubilee among the Jewish people, a time when people were released from their debts. Whatever debts they had, they were canceled during the Jubilee year. The symbol of anointing, that Matthew is going to be anointed by God, suggests a call that does not remain on the surface, but rather penetrates the core of a person, just as oil does not stay on the surface of our skin, but sinks into our bodies. When Jesus himself says he's been anointed by the Holy Spirit, it means that his mission is not a job or a career or a hobby, but rather the consequence and the expression of whom he really is. Now, Matthew will tell you that there was a time in his life when he believed his goal was to be something else. As he journeyed through life, however, he became conscious of a small voice that urged him to consider another way. No longer a career or a job, but rather a vocation in which God might use him to heal profoundly, to bind up hearts that have been broken, to announce release from the heaviest chains that human beings can bear, anything that would separate us from the fullness of life that God intends for women and men. So Matthew began a journey with the Franciscan community in which he and his confreres searched for the will of God. Now, discerning the vocation of a priest is not primarily trying to determine who is the holiest or who's the smartest. The most basic question is Matthew free to speak and to feed God's people in the name of Christ and his church? The authority of popes and bishops and priests in the church is authority to feed others, to nourish them, to care for them with pure doctrine and generous service, with truth and love, as someone called to serve as Jesus did. Now, God has made his entire people a royal priesthood in Christ by calling Matthew to the office of priests. God does not sever his relations with God's holy people. Rather, in intimate union with the order of bishops, Matthew is joined to in priestly office and called to the service of the people of God. God chooses him from a priestly people, just as he chose the apostles. Last Holy Thursday, our Holy Father, Pope Francis, described the connection between priests and the priestly people of God, comparing a mediator with a manager. The Holy Father said, "We know the difference between an intermediary and a manager, because a manager has already received his reward. And since he doesn't put his own skin and his own heart on the line, he never receives a heartfelt word of thanks." This is precisely the reason for the dissatisfaction of some who end up sad. Sad priests. In some sense, becoming collectors of antiquities or novelties, instead of being shepherds with the smell of the sheep on their skin. The Holy Father concluded, "This I ask of you. Be shepherds with the smell of the sheep. Make it real as shepherds among your flock, fishers of men. That you will be able to speak to the hearts of your people only if you know their joys and sorrows, their anxieties and their hope." Now this should not sound strange to you, since the charism of your religious family leads you to remain very close to the people of God through your gifts of fraternity and minority. As a Franciscan priest, you must never let the burden of administration or the pursuit of your own interests deafen you to the cry of brothers and sisters who, like you, search for God and hunger for God's word. Keep always before your eyes the image of the Good Shepherd who came not to be served, but to serve, and who came to seek out and save what is lost. Pope Benedict XVI taught that two things above all are asked of us priests. There is a need for an interior body, a configuration to Christ, and at the same time there has to be a transcending of ourselves, a renunciation of what is simply our own, of our much-wanted self-fulfillment. I need, not to claim my life as my own, but to place it at the disposal of another, at the disposal of Christ. Paul described to the Corinthians how his thinking about his life had changed through his friendship with Jesus Christ. His knowledge of Christ led Paul to reassess the ways of truly pleasing and serving God. His reevaluation indicates the profound and lasting effect of his experience of meeting Jesus on the way to Damascus some 20 years before. What he once thought to be important now no longer matters. What was absolutely necessary was to belong to Christ, to be configured to him. It was as if Paul himself stood with the other apostles on the night of that first day of the week, when the risen Lord bequeathed to his apostles his own mission, a mission of reconciliation. Matthew, in a few moments, I will present you with the bread and wine that will be offered in the name of God's holy people. As you receive them, I will ask you to know the word of God and imitate the mystery you celebrate, and model your life on the mystery of the cross. You will spend the rest of your life in the adventure of modeling your life on the mystery of the cross. As you move forward, the anointing you receive today will penetrate to your heart, and your life will reflect the mystery that you hold each day in your hands. The greatest love of all, a love that leads you each day to lay down your life for your friends. Like Francis, you will be shaped by the mystery of the cross, the mystery of reconciliation of the human race to God. Follow the example of your Holy Father, and allow that mystery to mark your body and your soul through the grace of the sacrament you receive. No one should ever have the impression that we priests work conscientiously only when we're on duty, but before and after hours we belong to ourselves. Matthew, a priest never belongs to himself. People must sense our zeal through which we bear credible witness to the cross of Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, let us ask the Lord to fill Matthew with joy in his message, so that he may serve his truth and his love with joyful zeal. Let us ask Mary, who is given as a mother always ready to help us, to fill Matthew with gratitude to God, who will